Hello friends, I am Professor S.B. Devre from KKWA College of Agriculture, Engineering and Technology, Nashik, Department of Soil and Water Conservation. Today we discuss about the construction of dam or earthen dams, requirement of earthen dams, environmental impact of earthen dams and uses of earthen dams. Construction of earthen dams. Earthen dams may be built on virtually any type of ground base except strongly efficient muddy soils. The watertight part of the dam, the baffle and core, is usually joined to the rocky base by cutoff or a concrete joint dunks, under which grouted cutoff reside in fissures rocks. On a non-rock base, if the water-resistant material, clay or rock, is located at an acceptable depth, the impermeable part of the dam is joined to the water-resistant material by a positive groundwater cutoff, a sheet pile, bulkhead or curtains. A blanket or a partial cutoffs and a sheet piles, bulkheads are installed for a deep-lying water supply. Are the material used for the construction of earthen dams? Fine aggregates, that is clay and silt. Clay size is less than 0.002 mm. The particle size less than 0.002 mm is clay. And silt particle size ranges in between 0.002 to 0.06 mm. Application of these fine aggregates is used for dam construction, embankments for roads, rail tracks and airport constructions, trenches and backfills, sanitary and landfill construction. Fine aggregates compactivity is difficult to compact due to cohesion. Compaction effect depends upon strongly on the water contents or amount of moisture present in that material. Material need high compaction energy. Compaction equipments generally heavy and medium size of single drum rollers, smooth and fat drums, trenches, compactor and heavy plates are used for the compaction. In a coarse aggregates, it is used for the embankments and sub-bases and bases for the roads, rail tracks and airport construction. Foundations for buildings, trenches and backfills. Sands particle size ranges from 0.06 to 2 mm and gravel size ranges from 2 to 60 mm. Compactability of this depends on the grading and too much compaction may be determined. Compaction equipment, that is vibratory tender rollers and single drum rollers, are used for the compactions. Heavy and medium size plates also used. In a rock fills, ovals and boulders, there is application for dam construction, embankments for roads, rail tracks and airport construction, foundation for buildings. Ovals has a greater than 16 mm size particle size and boulders having 100 mm size or more than 100 mm size. Compactability depends upon layer thickness should be 3 times thicker than maximum particle size. Material need high compaction energy and compaction equipment, generally heavy single drum rollers or heavy plates are used for their compactions. This is the earth dam design. This is the middle part of the, it shows the cross sectional area of earth dam. This is the middle side of the earthen dams. Here is the cutoff trench provided for to control the seepage from the upstream sides. This is the downstream side of the earth dams and this is the upstream side of the earth dams. Here is the water storage level of the earth dams. Small earthen dam design. A typical design of small earth fill dam is shown in figure, that is Here is the top width or crest width, that is 10 feet. Compacted impervious material is provided for to break the seepage line or meet the seepage line below the embankment, within the embankments. FSL means flood storage levels. Here is the freeboard. It is the additional height or vertical distance from the crest to the maximum water level to the crest of the dams. Erosion protections. For erosion protection, stone pitching or riprap is provided upstream and downstream side of the embankments. Upstream slope generally taken as 3:1 and downstream side taken as 2:1. It depends upon the materials. This is the typical dam layout. For stability, the upstream slope must be minimum of 3:1. Erosion protection is required to protect the dam from wave action. This protection can be achieved with a combination of smaller and larger rocks or other suitable materials. The downstream slope requires a minimum 2:1 slope, seeded with the native grasses to prevent surface erosion. The top or crest of the dam should be minimum of 2 meter width wide for a stable embankment structure. The crest elevation should be a minimum of 0.5 meter above the full supply level of the reservoir. The dam should be fenced to prevent livestock traffic, as well as this traffic can be major causes of a slope and crest degradation. A textbook perfect dam embankment structures would like to be the ones. The crest width and the slope of the embankments can be designed according to the guidelines. Here is the table shows the crest width based on the different dams embankments. Height of the dam up to 2 meter, the crest width should be at 2.5 meter. And the height of the dam ranges from 2.1 to 3 meter, that is crest width is 2.8 meter. The height of the dam is ranges from 3.1 to 4 meter, the crest width is 3 meter. And the height of the dam is ranges from 4.1 to 5, the crest width is 3.3 meter. Dam height in meters. Up to the 3 meters, upstream and downstream slopes according to the soil conditions provided 2.5:1, 2:1 for the sand and clay, 2.5:1 and 2:1. It depends upon the soil conditions generally. Here is the section or image shows the view of the earthen embankment. Here is the top width of the dam. Here is the spillway. This is the riprap or stone pitching provided to control, protect from the erosions. Here is the slope gravel, sand gravels material is used. Filter is generally used to remove the seepage water from the embankments. Here is the clay zone to meet the seepage or phreatic line within the embankment, or to create a core in the earthen embankment zone. Requirements of earthen dam. Basic requirement of an embankment dams are critical and essential part of the nations. Infrastructure for the storage and management of water in watersheds. To meet the dam safety requirements, the design, construction, operation, and modification of an embankment dam must comply with the following technical administrative requirements. Technical requirements that the dam foundation and abutments must be stable under all static and dynamic loading conditions. Seepage through the foundation, abutments, and embankment must be controlled and collected to ensure safe operations. The intent is to prevent excessive uplift pressure, piping of material, slogging, removal of material by solution or erosion of this material into cracks, joints, and cavities. In addition, the project purpose may impose a limitation on allowable quantity of seepage. The design should include seepage control measures such as foundation, cutoffs, and adequate and non-brittle impervious zone, transition zone, drainage material, and blankets. Upstream impervious blankets, adequate core contact area, and relief wells. The freeboard must be sufficient to prevent overtopping by waves and include and allowances for settlement of the foundation and embankment. The spillway and outlet capacity must be sufficient to prevent overtopping of the embankment by the reservoir. Administrative requirement, that is environmental responsibility and operational and maintenance of the earthen dams. Environment impacts on the construction of dams, that is river pollution, erosions, loss of aesthetic view, air pollution, noise pollution, or dust. Environmental impacts of reservoir, that is loss of land, habitat destruction. The area that is covered by the reservoir is destroyed, killing whatever habitat existed there before our hands. Loss of archaeological and historical places, loss of mineral deposits, loss of special geological formation, aesthetic view reduction, sedimentations, change in river flow regime and flood effects, reservoir induced seismicity, change in climate and plant species. Effect of dams on the water quality, change in temperature, increase in turbidity, dissolved gases in the water. Water discharge from the spillway contains 110 to 120% saturated nitrogen. This amount may be destructive for fish lives. Trophications, it means increase in vegetation if moss and other plant exist in the water, quality of that water gets worse. Use of earthen dams, generally of earthen dams is for generation of hydroelectricity, irrigation. These are often diversion dams which stop a river's natural course so that water can be sent off to a different places. Control floodings. These are called detention dams which are constructed to either stop or slow the amount of water in the rivers. This type of a dam is a good choice for a site with a wide valleys. Since they exert little pressure on their foundations, they can be built on a hard rock or a softer soils. Hydropower is often used in conjunction with the dams to generate electricity. A dam can also be used to collect water or for a storage of water which can evenly be distributed between locations. Modern mechanical excavation methods make possible construction of earthen dams to a height of 150 meters or more. Dam generally serves the primary purpose of the retaining water, while other structures such as floodgates are used to manage or prevent water flows into specific land regions.